Good morning once again from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston, a view inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room as a team of flight controllers watches over systems aboard the orbiting complex. The team today is led by Flight Director Ed Van Sice. He is serving as the lead for the team, overseeing this team throughout the daytime hours here in Houston, which is the essentially the midpoint of the crew's workday on orbit. Joining him is veteran astronaut Anna Fisher. She's handling the communications link between the Houston Flight Control Room, the team here in Mission Control, and the crew on board the International Space Station. The ISS is tracking around the Earth every 92 minutes at an altitude of about 250 statute miles, just about to move into an orbital sunset off the coast of Somalia, tracking southeasterly. It will take it high above the northern coastline of the island of Madagascar and then out over the Indian Ocean, and then skirting along the western coast of New Zealand, then out across the Pacific into an orbital sunrise. The crew on board the International Space Station Expedition 31 is made up of Commander Oleg Kononenko. You see in the center of the picture. On the right in this view is European Space Agency astronaut André Kuipers from the Netherlands. And on the left is astronaut from the United States Don Pettit. All three crew members have previous spaceflight experience, and they're now in their 141st day in space, 139 of those aboard the International Space Station on a long-duration mission, headed for a total of about 193 days before they return home on their scheduled date of Sunday, July 1st. On this Wednesday on board the station, the crew is focusing on a number of activities around the station. They're spread out in three different locations, with Don Pettit working with some cargo transfer from the automated transfer vehicle number 3, the Eduardo Amaldi, supplied to the station program by the European Space Agency. He's also been working a great deal of time in a rack associated with the combustion experiment on board the station as well. He's been working with swapping out one of the fluid tanks associated with that piece of hardware that takes up almost an entire rack assembly inside the station's Destiny laboratory. Kuipers spent the day cleaning filters in three of the U.S. Connecting nodes, and also working with the Japanese Kibo laboratory, straightening it up ahead of the arrival later this summer of the third H2 transfer vehicle that's provided to the International Space Station program by the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency. And Commander Oleg Kononenko is working in the Russian segment of the station. He's been using a countermeasure system to take readings of any harmful contaminants in that Russian segment, the Zvezda module, which serves as the command and control function of the Russian segment of the station.